Obsidian 1.5 just dropped for the insiders. It brings several nice features, including a very much expected one. Let's take a quick look at the highlights together. Here are the official release notes. And the first item is a new table editor as a core feature of Obsidian. Let's insert a new table. I call the columns C1 and C2, and in the cells below, we have C1 R1, C2 R1, C1 R2, and C2 R2. Not very creative, but that's fine. Unfortunately, there is no R2 D2. If I right click inside the table, the context menu lets me add, move, duplicate or delete rows and columns. For example, I can click in the first column and choose Add Column to the right. I will call this column C3, but C3 is not in the right place. Now, I could again use the context menu to move the column to the right or, and this is really nice, I can use the new handles for dragging the column to where I want it to be. The same is true for rows, of course. A few things to consider. First, this only works in the live preview mode for editing, not in the source mode. Second, you can still use the advanced tables plugin, but I recommend unbinding the enter and tab key via the settings. Just go to Obsidian Settings, Advanced Tables, and deactivate the first two options. If you don't do that, the Enter and Tab keys will take you out of the table instead of moving from cell to cell. And third, for the time being at least, I had to disable the Language Tool Integration plugin for the table editor to work. When it was enabled, I could not enter any text into the table. As the plugin creators also just got this version, I suggest being patient. I'm sure this will be addressed very soon. The next section is a short one and it deals with the onboarding experience. Two things here. One, Obsidian now respects your system settings for light or dark theme, which is nice. And two, when creating a new vault from scratch, we now get a new welcome experience. We move on to the properties section. This may seem small, but it's actually really helpful. We can now rename properties globally and the change will be applied to all related files. And case insensitive search is also nice. Let's check the search first. I search for test in lowercase and Obsidian does indeed find my test property with an uppercase T. Now I can rename it and see the name change applied in my test node here. This release also allows us to search for nodes where a certain property has the value true, false, or is empty. Let me try to find all the nodes where I did my planned workout. I go to search, select property, enter workout, and true. Yep, that looks about right. Another new search feature is that we can use inequality operators. For example, I can easily find all the nodes where I tracked more than 20 pushups. Once again, I select the property, in this case pushups, and add the operator greater than 20. Then we have a number of improvements for the editing experience, starting with callouts. I quickly create a new callout. Let's make it a bug. By the way, if you like this way of creating callouts, check the link in the description. I explain how to set this up in another video. As of this version, we are able to right-click on a callout when in live preview and change its type. So I will just change this one from a bug to an information callout. As you can see, this works very nicely. Here's another nice little change. When typing, auto-completion for hashtags now uses the highlighted suggestion and, if it is a nested tag, hitting the tab key will complete the tag by a segment instead of all at once. Then there is a bunch of quality of life improvements. None of them is revolutionary by itself, but in total, some really good changes that make working in Obsidian even nicer. I hope this quick overview of what is to come in the latest version of Obsidian was helpful. If you found this video even remotely helpful, perhaps drop a like, subscribe to the channel, and ring the notification bell to make sure you won't miss the next videos. If you want to learn more about Obsidian, check out this growing list of videos. Also, if you have a specific request or question, just let me know in the comments. I'm always happy to oblige, if I can. And that's it for today. Thanks for watching and see you next time.